Thanks for joining us. My name's Todd O'Hair. I'm the president and CEO of the Montana Chamber of Commerce. And thanks for joining us here for our weekly Capital Connection. We'll be doing this every week at noon and then resharing the recorded version of this on Mondays. And so our intent with this on a weekly basis here is to just provide a real high level overcap of the week that has just concluded and to look into next week for some of the major issues that are facing the business community and some of the work that we are pursuing on behalf of the business community. And so this first portion will be recorded, which we figure will last about 10 minutes. And then after that, we will stop the recording and then open it up for any questions that we may have from any of you that are participating here. And so after the recording stops, when Bridger and I stop our dialogue, please feel free to jump in with any sort of questions or comments or thoughts that you might have. This is a good opportunity to kind of catch up and offer some insights from the business community. So with that, Bridger Mahlum, our Government Affairs Director for the Montana Chamber of Commerce. So Bridger, what's the big highlights from week two of the session?
Well, week two, here we are. I'm looking at this and I realize I need to like get a booster seat or something to somehow measure up to your stature here. We'll have to figure that out for next time. But yeah, week two, things remain exciting. One of the kind of overarching things I'm seeing, at least through my experience, having done this for a couple sessions now, is we're seeing that relatively slow trickle of bills coming in during that first week. Again, it's all about new legislators getting acclimated to the process. But now that we're in week two, we're starting to see a little bit more of like a regular hearing schedule of committees. And I think we're just going to be starting to see more bills coming with each consecutive day at this point. So rolling along.
So one of the big priorities that the chamber had rolling into the session was COVID liability for business. We had a hearing a week ago. What's the status on that?
Yeah, Todd, we've got some great news to share for one of our top priority bills, Senate Bill 65. Executive action took place in the Senate Business and Labor Committee this morning. And with what we believed were friendly amendments put forth by the sponsor of the bill, Senator Steve Fitzpatrick, our champion on this issue this session, it passed out of committee 8-3 with both Republicans and a Democrat supporting it. So we're going to claim bipartisanship on that, and we're looking forward to seeing that move to the Senate floor here. It should be in a matter of days. Usually when an executive action takes place in a bill, it's no more than a couple days before it gets into second reading on the full Senate. But with the amendments on it, we feel good about where this is going.
Great. And this is a priority for Governor Gianforte moving forward.
Oh, 100%. And given that press conference that he had just at pretty much at the beginning of this session, noting that to really get our economy restarted again and to get not only the consumer confidence back, but the business confidence, was that these liability certainties needed to be in place. And so we continue to look forward to that partnership that we've already been achieving with the governor's office on this bill. So really exciting news indeed.
So with the vote on the full Senate expected next week, what do you think the prospects are? Do we still have problems with legislators in support of this, or do you think we're going to be okay?
Well, that's a crystal ball I'm still working out with each conversation I have with a legislator, pulling them aside in the halls or a phone call or a text or email, any way to get a hold of these folks and make the best case we can. And I'll tell you, Todd, what really drives a lot of what the legislator's perspective is on a bill is what they're hearing from their constituents. And that sounds like that's a no-brainer, and it is. And I think what it speaks to, and for folks that are listening to this video, is that if you're a business owner, you shouldn't be afraid to reach out to your local lawmaker, because you have more influence in this process than perhaps any lobbyist who's up here and paid full time to do it. So I'd just revert that more or less to a call to action as we continue to, if this bill matters to you, please check in with your local lawmakers, House or Senate, because this is going to go to the House eventually, should all things go the way we expect them to. And we need to continue that grassroots drive, showing that there is a need for this legislation, as we believe there is.
So let's talk about the red tape task force that the governor created an executive order around on his first week in office. This was a big priority for the Montana Chamber coming into the legislative session. We wanted to do something with regulations and some of the overextension of government agencies into business matters here. What can you tell us about the governor's action on the executive order?
Well, as the Montana Chamber, we have a lot to be excited about over the Red Tape Relief Advisory Council, because this lines up almost directly with potential legislation we were working on with some lawmakers and the governor's office leading up to this session. And to see that our new governor has created this kind of task force is going to be really important for regulation going forward. And I mean, I'll hit on a few of the highlights of what it's tasked to do. It's going to obviously look at excessive, outdated, and unnecessary regulations, anything that's especially burdensome on Montana farmers, ranchers, and business owners, anything that disproportionately impacts small business. And of course, in the pursuit of doing that, they're going to look at quantitative and qualitative metrics to measure that implementation by agency. And so the composition of this thing right now, the required members, but it's not limited to this, is that it would include Lieutenant Governor Kristen Juris, as well as an employee from each state agency authorized to issue regulations. So you're having representation from every portion of government. But the key aspect of this is that it's not limited to these individuals. So we want to make sure that in some form, and as this thing continues to evolve, that there is a strong presence of industry perspective involved in this, because we are the folks that are directly burdened by unnecessary regulation, and we want to have responsible regulation, just as the motivations would entail with the executive order itself. So we'll be involved with that.
Great. So we'll continue working with the governor's office on that, and we've got a great relationship with the new governor. We've started off with a bang there, and we look forward to continuing that relationship as things get going. So next week, real quickly, what do you see on the horizon for next week that we need to be paying attention to?
Yeah, there's a couple of bills that stand out to me as I'm doing an initial review of next week. And for as many issues as the Montana Chamber touches, I'm often just a few days ahead of myself when it comes to the hearings. And bills are put on the calendar with very little notice. So what I talk about right now are going to be important bills to watch, but there's no telling what else could be added to the hearing schedule next week. So one of them is there's going to be a hearing next week on Senate Bill 51, which was a proposal that was brought forth last session that would ensure temporary property tax relief for broadband providers that are seeking to be able to justify investments into more rural areas where broadband is lacking. So that's going to be an important incentive, not only for infrastructure investment, but also for our entrepreneurs, where that conventional, like, building your business out of a garage mantra, you need internet to do anything anymore. And so we want to make sure rural Montana has an opportunity to start its own business and deal with that. So that's certainly one that we would highlight for next week that we're going to have a major interest in. As well as another piece of legislation that I'm really just going to preview here. I anticipate the hearing to be next week, but it's not entirely confirmed at this time, is House Bill 158 establishes a study commission to review rule suspensions during COVID-19, which is really an interesting concept brought forth by Representative Caleb Hinkle out of the Belgrade area, new legislator. Is working with a few stakeholders and has reached out to us for our input on this idea of getting lawmakers and other stakeholders into a task force over the course of the upcoming interim that will look at each regulation and rule that was justifiably suspended or had to be temporarily put off in order to get through COVID-19. And what it's going to do is say, look, is it necessary to bring this regulation back now that we've been able to live without it? And that's really an astute question to ask with all this stuff. Telehealth is a really good example of one of those things that's going to have to be examined really closely. If that's been a proven success, why do we need to automatically revert back to not having it if it's working? So we'll be curious to see how that bill goes, and we might end up engaged in that one. We'll see.
So those are the big issues that you can see right now for next week.
Yeah, one more procedural matter that might be of interest to some folks that view this is that the bill draft request deadline is next week, early next week. And so once Tuesday, the end of Tuesday hits, lawmakers can't request any more bill titles. So then we'll absolutely be where we are when it comes to the 3,200 bill titles out there. We know there won't be any more added. So when it comes to what the playing field looks like, we will start to have more certainty going into next week from that procedural standpoint. So I'm personally excited about that.
Hopeful.
Because it's just a spigot right now of bill titles that we have to keep track.
Well, great. Well, for those of you, keep in mind that this is the recorded version and we'll be putting this out again next week. If you want to see what the Montana Chamber priorities are, it's on our prosperity plan. You can go to the Montana Chamber website and look under the news tab there, and we've got it in the press release, and there's a link in there that you can click on that to see the full list of what our proactive priorities are today related to business. So with that, we'll stop.